Usually, whenever you hear the words quantum mechanics, you think to yourself, oh god, please anything but this. Believe it or not, you have one thing in common with Einstein. He didn't like it either, no matter how much it proves to be true. You see, when it comes to tiny particles, you can't really use any device to measure any precise information about them without affecting what you're measuring, because those devices need to use other particles like photons. These photons carry enough energy to change the particle's properties. So, quantum mechanics solved this by introducing the concept of uncertainty, which says that subatomic particles don't really exist anywhere. They are like ghosts. They are everywhere. Until you attempt to look at them, they appear somewhere. So it is impossible to know the particle's speed, location, or energy. You can only apply external forces and observe how it affects them, even if you had perfect devices. Which sounds spooky. So, he came up with a thought process to prove that this is not true. Imagine a scale that is so perfect, it can measure the weight of subatomic particles. On it, a box with one single particle inside. If we make a hole in the box and the particle gets out, we would be able to see the change in the box weight. If you know the particle's weight, you can know its energy. And the change in the weight can even tell you the exact moment the particle left the box. Proving that physics does allow us to know information about particles. This is a very simplified version of what went on to be known as Einstein's box, which was part of a very famous and complicated debate between Einstein and Niels Bohr, who was famous for his work on quantum mechanics. The debate went on for years. Every time Einstein would propose an idea to disprove quantum theory, Bohr would strike back with an answer to disprove his disproof. While quantum mechanics went on to be the most successful theory in history, after Bohr's death, people found a drawing of Einstein's box on his board. This is to show that even a legendary Nobel Prize winner like Bohr can have doubts about his work till his last moments.